You want to create your own VFox experiments, but working with XML is a hurdle for you? Then VFox now offers a solution. The new Blockly-based VFox editor makes creating experiments as easy as solving a puzzle. In this video, I will show you how to create your own first experiment. During this process, you will learn the basic structure and the most important functions. To do this, I will implement a variation of the roll experiment to determine the rolling velocity on an inclined plane. This experiment reads the y-axis of the smartphone's gyroscope to obtain the angular velocity of the rolling motion and allows the user to input the radius of the roll to calculate the roll's velocity. Let's open the link to the new editor where you will see this interface. Before we start creating the experiment, I want to briefly explain the interface to you. In the top left, there are 6 work areas that make up components of the experiment. Directly below that, on the left side, you will see a column of functions and blocks which you can use to build your experiments. In the center, you will see the main function block, which you will populate with your blocks. On the right, there is a separate workspace for the data containers or variables that you will use in your experiment. In the top right corner, you will find functions like generate and load, as well as reset to reset the editor in order to create a new experiment. Load allows you to load one of the pre-installed experiments or your own experiments that you already downloaded. Generate lets you download the experiment. In the first workspace, main, we can set up how the experiment is shown in the app. We'll start by entering the name, inclined plane. Select the category, example, choose the color blue, and enter a short description, such as test experiment for the inclined plane. Let's continue with the input tab. Here we decide which sensor of the smartphone we want to use to record the measurement data. To do this, we simply drag the sensor block into the central function block. For the inclined plane experiment, we work with the gyroscope, which we use to measure the angular velocity of the smartphone around its longitudinal axis. To do this, we select the gyroscope from the drop-down menu and open the settings via the gear icon. Here, we activate the y-axis of the gyroscope and the time output. Since the measurement frequency of sensors can vary between different smartphones, it is advisable to set a fixed rate at which we read the measurement values. The average function can also reduce noise by measuring the values between readings. Let's move on to the output tab. Here, you can implement outputs on the smartphone, such as an audio signal or a connection to a Bluetooth device. For our experiment, this is not necessary. Next is the analysis tab, where we can set the necessary mathematical operations with the variables we need for our experiments. However, we should create these variables first. As you can see, the containers for angular velocity, y1, and for time, t1, have already been added automatically when setting up the input. By pressing the Add Container button, you can add new variables. We still need a variable r for the radius, vms for the velocity in meters per second, and vkmh for the velocity in kilometers per hour. After we have created the variables, we will now set up the calculations. We need multiplication, which can be found in a block for basic arithmetic operations in the basic math section. Here you see 2 gaps, which you need to fill with the input blocks. So we drag the variable blocks into the gaps to set the factors and select in the respective drop-down menus multiplication and the factors radius and angular velocity, with the product being the speed in meter per second. Subsequently, we can duplicate the entire block by right-clicking to also add the calculations for kilometers per hour. To do this, press the plus sign to add another factor and drag the block for constants from the input blocks. We select the conversion factor 3.6. Now, there are 2 important settings. After VFox has performed a calculation, the factors are usually deleted. To avoid this, we activate the Keep function in the Settings menu. For the first of the 2 calculations, we need to activate this for both the radius and angular velocity. For the lower of the 2 calculations, we must turn off Keep for the measurement data so that the already converted values are deleted after the calculation and are not recalculated in the next cycle. The second important setting concerns the products. In the settings menu, we need to activate the append function so that new values do not overwrite the old ones, but rather are appended to the already calculated values. With that, we can move on to view. Let's start by building the interface shown here. To set up the interface as shown on the right, we start with the edit block, which allows us to input the radius. We choose the description radius r equals and as the variable r. We open the settings and can configure the input accordingly. Here it's worth mentioning that if you are ever unsure about what a specific function does, you can use the help function via right click, which will open the wiki entry for that block. As you can see on the right, we want to allow input of the radius in decimal numbers and in the unit centimeters. So let's check that decimal is activated and enter cm as the unit below. Now it's important to remember the calculations. The calculations with the angular velocity expect the radius in meters. We can set the conversion here using a factor of 100. Here we can also set a default value, which should be preset when the experiment opens. The typical roll will have a radius of about 5 cm, but we need to set this in meters, so 0.05. We close the settings. Now I want to show you how to plot the velocity. You drag the graph block and fill it with the x-axis and y-axis blocks. In the drop-down menu, you select time for the x-axis and speed in meter per second for the y-axis. Through the gear icon of the graph block, you can access many settings to refine the graph. For most purposes, it should suffice to label the axis here. Next, we want to set up the second tab in VFox. This is particularly easy by duplicating the entire view block. Then we only need to adjust the labels and select the correct variable for the y-axis. With that, the view setup is complete. Finally, let's configure the datasets that we want to make available through the app's export function. Our goal is to create the Excel sheet on the right. To do this, we select the set block and name it experiment. Next, we fill it with data blocks and select the radius, time and speed in meter per second from the drop-down menus. We choose appropriate labels for the blocks, and with that, our export is configured. Now we hit the generate button. A new window opens where you can see the XML code that we have just assembled. Easy, right? By clicking download, you can download the experiment file, or by selecting QR code online, you can generate a QR code that you can scan directly from VFox to import your experiment. With that, the experiment configuration is fully assembled, and you can start measuring. Have fun!